Welcome back to our YouTube channel, guys. Today is all about this car, BMW 1 Series. This is having what's called System Level 2, which you can find on our website as different packages for the BMW range. In terms of what we've got in the car currently is a factory fitted radio, and this car has the base sound system. We're going to be upgrading a new tweeter, new 4-inch, soundproofing the door, and then upgrading these, adding new amplification as well. So let's go through some of the products that we've got going into the car. To start with, we've got a little drawing here of exactly what's going in. Obviously we have the factory head unit, however our customer wanted to add Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, so we're adding that in, so that will integrate all into the factory screen. So it'll be a whole nother video on the CBS Automotive YouTube channel of that install. So if you're just after CarPlay, that'll be on that channel, which is on our main homepage. Basically what we've got going here, CarPlay into the factory radio, that will lead into an amplifier, then we're going to have new components, so a new tweeter mid-range into the doors, and then the woofers underneath the seats. So this is System Level 2. We have Level 1, Level 2, Level 3, Level 4, and plenty of options in between that as well if you want something completely custom. But a bit of an overview of some of the products that we've got going in here. The actual looms, they all go, so we pick up factory harnesses inside the vehicle. As you can see, they are plug and play looms. There is still quite a lot involved. I don't quite like using the word plug and play because a lot of these systems are still quite heavily involved in terms of the install. The actual amplifier, so this is where we're going to add a lot more power, a lot more volume to the system. This is what's called an SR500 amp, a really nice, quite large amplifier actually. So it's really, really impressive. It's got a nice amount of weight to it. Underneath here, you've got all the gain control, so we'll be adjusting that, setting that all up really professionally and properly inside the vehicle. That is basically the power driving the system. So we've got 5 channels of amplification here, and that is going to be running this system. So we're going to be running channels across for the front end in terms of the tweeters and mid-range, and then on to the 5th channel will be for the woofers. In terms of the front speakers here, what have we actually got? These are all from the Audison Prima range in terms of the components. We've got a new tweeter, but you might be thinking, obviously you saw earlier, there's no space for this. So that's why we've actually ordered in the Harman Kardon surround and grill. So on top of the price of the packages that you see on the website, you need to add anywhere between 50 to about £150 for the additional grille. So this allows us to replace it, keep it with a really nice stock look. Basically looks like it has Harman Kardon, but it sounds way, way better than Harman Kardon. We're gonna take out that tweeter, replace it and upgrade it with the Audison Prima tweeter. Then inside the door behind stock location, we're gonna have the Audison Prima 4-inch. Then underneath the seats, we're going for the Audison Prima 8-inch drivers underneath the seats. They're all gonna be powered from that 5-channel amp. Basically, the difference between when you go up to level 3 is the addition of processor, rear speakers, and also a lot more tuning goes into actually getting the system sounding even better than what we're going to have here. However, this is a really, really nice stage. This will give you an increase in volume, increase in clarity, increase in bass. So overall, a really nice difference, but we're mostly only focusing on the front end here. So they're the components. Later on in the video, we'll do a bit of a side-by-side comparison. Once we've got those speakers out of the car, you'll be seeing side-by-side each one of these 3 compared to the factory system. So that'll be quite nice for you guys to see a little bit later on. But now we've got plenty of work to do in terms of the install. In terms of soundproofing, which we'll show you in a little bit, we'll do a little knock test to show you the difference that makes. And we're adding 15 sheets of soundproofing into this system. And then later on, obviously, we're going to be having CarPlay, new amplification, front speakers, under seats. Yeah, this one is going to be absolutely lovely. I can't wait to share the rest of the journey with you guys. So we've stripped the door down and there is basically a little cover that sits across here. So that has now been removed. Inside behind here, what we're actually going to be doing is fully soundproofing all behind this layer here. So at the moment, it's extremely tinny. So you can hear that. So I'll do that same knock test once all of that soundproof. So we've got 15 sheets going in terms of skin soundproofing. It's a 3mm layer of acoustic soundproofing. So I'll show you that in a little bit. But that's going to be going on the back here, then across this panel, and then a little bit on the back of the door card. The 4-inch driver is going to sit into stock location here, and then on top of the door, around about here, we're going to have the new component, which is going to be the tweeter, which the car was lacking because of the driver. The tweeter wasn't there because they had the base system. Underneath the actual seat, this is the location for where the new Audison Prima 8-inch woofer is going to be sitting underneath there, so that is going to be completely hidden out of sight. And in essence, it's going to look like this car has Harman Kardon. There's no real cosmetic difference other than obviously that cosmetic grille of that tweeter. It's basically going to look like it has Harman Kardon, but sound way, way better, which is exactly what our client is looking for. Now time for that side-by-side comparison of the components. So what we've got here, firstly, the grills. So these are the stock grills that came with the car on the base hi-fi system. If you have Harman Kardon, then obviously we don't need to order these in for you. But if you do have the base system like this client, we've got this new grill in from BMW. So what we're going to be doing is adding a tweeter in. Currently, the system from the base system doesn't have a tweeter, so we'll be adding in the Prima tweeter into this new grill, basically hidden behind there, so it looks really nice and stock. So this is a 4-inch component inside the door, so this will be hidden behind the stock location. So this is the factory component. I mean, really, really poor quality. It's plastic structure, paper cone design, really, really poor there. Then we've got the Audison Prima. I mean, if I put these side by side here, you'll be able to see exactly what I'm on about. Just see the magnet size difference there. So hopefully that gives you guys a little bit of a better idea about what that is gonna do over that. But we will be listening to the car a little bit later on so you can hear the difference that this makes. So even if you are doing system level one, where basically we're upgrading these two and not adding the amplifier in, this is still a massive, massive difference. But if you really want that volume difference and want that clarity and help these perform how they can, that's where you go for system level two, three and upwards. Then moving over, we've actually got the underseat woofers. So these are the new Audison Prima range. Then these are the ones that were underneath the seat. So as you can see here, they come in like this plastic housing. So this will actually come out of it. These will then go in. So you can kind of see if we put that together like that, they will actually go directly into that stock location. And you can see by the connector as well that it's exactly the same here. So that will be upgraded into this plastic housing. However, we don't just leave it as that. What we do is we soundproof underneath the seat. So now I'm going to show you a little bit of soundproofing actually inside the door and what difference that makes. We have the factory BMW 1 Series door card. What we're going to be doing is applying soundproofing to this panel, but also securing some of these clips. So you'll note here, if I don't know if you're able to hear it, but so there's quite a lot of movement in that clip just from factory, just how they're designed. So what we're going to be doing is actually taping these up to make sure they're really nice, snug and secure, and they're not going to be rattling around. So that is really important whenever we're doing a system, that those sorts of things are all done as a fundamental. So as you can see, we're applying soundproofing to behind here. So this is the 3mm layer. So what Steve's doing at the moment, he's got a heat gun and he's basically cutting little holes in the soundproofing to be going around obviously where factory bolt positions are, so everything can be reversed. And also anyone going into this door, it all makes sense to them in the future. They're not having to strip any of our work away. Plus it's still providing a massive increase in actual kind of performance inside this door. So that is it being applied right now. So basically you heat it up, then as you can see, it gets rolled on to basically really give a nice solid area and really nice support onto here, and it will go right into the crevice, just into that area there. Perfect. And as you can see, it's all behind here now. And then so there's 15 sheets going into the actual system itself, but that is now pretty much ready. And we've got a couple more areas to do on the back of the door card, and we'll shoot obviously those clips that you saw earlier, we're going to be securing them in as well. So now what we're doing is cutting out the area for where the speaker is going to go. This is really important because when the speaker then gets mounted in, it actually is sealed all the way around, which is quite nice. And then what Steve just done there is mounted that right behind, I won't be able to get the camera in there, but right behind that area, again reflecting all of that sound, keeping it inside the vehicle, reducing that road noise, and also building a better environment for the system to work in. So that is basically the soundproofing. So we'll show you the finished results when it's all done and all going back together. So just to show you guys some of the wiring, we've got a pre-made loom that runs front to back from the factory radio in the car. Obviously we are adding Apple CarPlay and Android Auto into that as well. In terms of what Carl's doing at the moment in terms of these cables, he's just making sure all the joints are all soldered, then heat shrink, and they're all going to be nicely taped up. We've got the input and output in this loom, so this will then go into the amplifier, and that is all going to be all dressed really neatly. The amplifier is going to live in this little compartment, hidden away out of sight down in that pocket. Then we're going to run our powers and everything over to the battery here. So obviously it's not a long cable run for your powers, however all of the cable runs do run front to back for the loom, for outputs going to the new speakers as well as all the inputs, so we have everything we need to make it sound absolutely incredible. So now it's time to show you some of the wiring that we've done. So we've got our positive power lead that runs all the way across alongside manufacturer wiring over to the new amplifier. What we've actually done to install this here is actually installed a full carpeted backboard, mounting the Audison SR5 amplifier here. We've got all of the terminals going in terms of inputs and outputs, powers along the top there. And then we've also got all the high level inputs as well. So you see the cover is actually off here currently. So we'll be actually setting all of these gains and by voltage. We'll be setting the system so it's all nice and safe, ready for our client to use, turn it up and really enjoy the system, but making sure everything is protected and safe. Obviously the factory panel will cover all of this as well as all of this. The factory floor will sit on top of here. No space loss at all, but a massive difference in sound. Now let's head over to the door and show you what we've got going on there. Inside here we've now got the new Audison Prima 4-inch component, obviously all fully soundproofed, and we've got all the clips nice and secure, so no longer rattling around at all. And we've got a little bit more soundproofing on here. There is more that can be done in terms of soundproofing, and that's obviously dependent on different levels that you go for. This has 15 sheets of soundproofing across the front doors, so this is basically pretty much mostly covered. Probably get a little bit more on here, but this is going to give you a real nice difference in terms of actual sound quality, punch of sound, and really helping that mid-range perform, as well as reducing some of that road noise as well. So let's quickly do a little bit of a knock test. So this panel is not soundproof, so I'm going to knock on here and you'll be able to hear the difference. And then if I go over to this door here, so extremely solid, a massive difference. I'll go back to this door just so you can hear again. So hopefully that comes across well on camera, but yeah, massive difference, making everything a lot more solid. And that's obviously just one layer on the outside. Obviously you've got soundproofing here now, as well as the back of the door card. So it's now time to get the car back together, completed, and then have a listen to it to show you exactly how good this system sounds. So it's now finally time to have a listen to the system. So the install has been done within the 3 days. We've now got the Harman Kardon grills in here for the tweeters. We've got the upgraded floor, soundproofing and the under seat. So we've also, as you can see now, upgraded the factory radio to have Apple CarPlay as well as Android Auto. So let's have a listen to it. And how you don't know how to keep your business clean.
I don't know. I mean, overall, absolutely fantastic difference here. The clarity is massively transformed, and that's down to those tweeters, as well as the new power from the system. The system sounds really powerful, nice and punchy. Overall, really happy. Level 2 system completed. We're just about to hand over a system that we've just done on level 3, which does sound a little bit nicer, sounds a bit more full, because you've got the rear speakers then running, as well as a process. We get a little bit more time tuning, but yeah. Overall, absolutely love the system. It's a massive difference for the car, and I'm sure our client is going to absolutely love it as well. Just having the car sounding absolutely brilliant now. You've got a really stock look, obviously added functionality of the Apple CarPlay as well, which is really nice. But yeah, overall, over the moon with the finished results. So thank you so much for watching. Smash that subscribe button, and we'll see you on the next one.